It's 5 o'clock in the morning. Conversation got boring. You said you'd go into bed soon, so I snuck off to your bedroom. And I thought I'd just wait there until I heard you come upstairs. And I pretended I was sleeping, and I was hoping you.
It's 5 o'clock in the morning, and I want you, and you want me, don't you? I can see it, 'cause you've been waiting on me since I said that I was hitting the club. The sun be coming up on me, and I know you be getting so horny, 'cause you be sending me texts like, boy, just get your ass up in that car and come get all of this love. You ain't gotta remind me. She already said if I don't come on time, she might go crazy. And she'll be waiting on me naked with one of my chains on. She might come and find me, oh, and then ask me kindly, oh, do I want her to go crazy? We do this every night and then we always wake up singing the same
it's
song.
It's 5 o'clock in the morning. Yeah. Conversation got boring.
Talk to me, girl.
You said you'd go into bed soon. So I snuck off to your bedroom.
Come on.
And I thought I'd just wait there.
Wait on
until
me.
Until I heard you come up the stairs.
I won't let you stay lonely.
And I pretended I was sleeping.
Alright.
I was hoping you were creeping.
Good night, it's 5 o'clock in the morning. Conversation got boring. You said you're going to bed soon. So I snuck off to your bedroom. And I thought I'd just wait there. Upstairs, and I pretend that I was sleeping. Oh, I was hoping you was creeping. It's 5 o'clock in the morning, and you calling. And these females got me stalling. I can hear your voice in my head like, what is he doing? Oh, what is he doing? 'Cause I keep checking my cell phone and these missed calls. And you texting me like I'ma kill y'all if you don't get your ass up out of that club. And do you know what time it is?
So good evening to my YouTube family, specifically all of my lock stars. Blessings to you. I don't know if I would refer to this segment as a rant, a vlog, however you want to call it. It's just some things that I was thinking about since early this morning, since realistically probably about 2:30. The last video that I did, I had a lot of feedback, a lot of positives, some that was a bit middle of the line. Maybe I didn't understand, but you know, I really thank you for the input anyway. On the last one that I did in regards to not taking the time to nurture my locks on my own. So to everyone that responded to that video, I thank you. I thank you so much. On tonight, I have something in my mind that is a concern. I had someone on Facebook, a friend from that I've known for many years, a friend, and she, whom will remain nameless, sent me a friend request. So I, you know, of course I accepted it and had seen her in some time. And you know how time transpires and you don't hear from them and you don't see them. And especially when you go through the phase of you trying to reconnect, it could be days or even weeks between the messages that you get. Maybe that's just me. She sent me a message. Like I said, I accepted the request. And the conversation started off about 3 weeks ago. And I responded with, how have you been? And she said, oh, you know, I've been well. I haven't seen you in a while. And fast forward to about a week later, the conversation continues. And she says, I didn't recognize you. And I was like, really? Why not? And her response was that you've changed so much. I said, in my mind, I immediately begin to start. The wheels are turning. I'm like, well, I haven't seen you in the better part of 6 or 7 years, so how do you know how much I've changed? And my mind evolved. And I said, so my response was, and I want to make sure that I say this accurately and correctly. My response was, how so? And get ready for this. Just really, really grab hold to your seats and get ready for this. My response to her question when I asked, how so? She responded to me, your overall look, it's so thuggish. I was like, bombs over Baghdad at that point. I was in awe. I've known her for so many years, and I was really, literally in shock. I don't want to be petty. I'm reaching out to my lot community to ask. I really hope that I'm not being petty, but I'm looking above and beyond. So I asked her, what makes me look thuggish? And she based it solely upon the fact that the last time she saw me, I had a brush cut, but I have waves, you know? And now she sees me and I have the locks. So she based her opinion upon me simply nothing more than the fact that she saw me now and I have locks. I took offense to that. I really did. I took offense to that. Ladies, if I were to walk up to one of my closest friends, if I were to walk up to someone who I've not seen in 5 or 6 years, and the last time I saw them, they had, let's just say for point of conversation, the Halle Berry bob, and all of a sudden, and let's just say she's a Caucasian woman, and next I see her, she has braids or cornrows or whatever, and my response is, wow, you look different. And she says, how so? I'm like, you look ghetto now. Is that offensive? The thing is walk with me. Walk with me on this one and understand my sense of reason. It wasn't about the fact of what she said to a total degree about my locks. Since I began my journey, I began to think about a lot of things. And what she said to me made me go back in time because she is a Mexican-American woman. And if we do not understand our history, we are doomed to repeat it. And we had conversation back and forth. I was like, do not misconstrue the fact and forget that we are both minorities. And ultimately, what you did to me was you based your entire judgment and perception, reality, thought pattern, process, everything you wanted to formulate, every opinion in your mind about me based upon solely what you saw. Is that not a form of prejudice? Is that not? I'm only asking, please, give me your feedback. To me, in essence, that is no more different than you basing an opinion on me based upon the color of my skin. If every rapist, murderer, child molester, woman abuser drove a Cadillac Escalade. If I decided to take my hard-earned money that I worked so hard for and buy that vehicle simply based upon the mechanics of it, the fine automobile, the features and benefits that I happen to like that it presents to me. Now, if I decide to go and buy and purchase that vehicle, does that give someone the right to look at me and say, oh, you're a thug or a drug dealer or a rapist or a child molester? Or simply because I think that is a little extreme. And let me bring this back into full circle. This is the reason why. A box, please do not put me in. I ask of you, please do not put me in a box. The thing is that when you make up your mind and you make a conscious decision that you are going to be different from the norm, you are going to always face adversity. There's always going to be a resistance towards you. And it's amazing to me that people formulate an opinion about you simply based upon the fact that you decide to change a physical attribute. So never mind the fact. I need to digress. I don't rant. I really don't rant. But this affected me, and it just made me really focus on something. So never mind my financial stature, my educational background, my Christian background, my family orientation, the heart that I have to give to, never mind none of that. You simply formulated opinion based upon the outside world and what you see. You see these and you say all of a sudden I am thuggish. It brought it to full circle. It really did. It's not about the locks. It really made me understand that when you decide to do something different and you realize that you know who you are and you refuse to conform, you refuse to be like everyone else, when you decide to be an individual, please understand the life learned lesson that I've learned along this journey is that is always going to come with criticism, with jealousy, with it's amazing. It is amazing to me. Now I'm reaching and I'm asking a lot of all the people that watch my videos that have been posting comments and different things like that. Get at me. Let me know what you feel about that. I'm passionate about that. I'm passionate about that. Each one, teach one. I'm not upset with her because she did that and because she said that. I'm concerned with the fact that ignorance is so bliss that we cannot, or I cannot, change something about myself without it being, without someone deriving it a negative connotation about myself, formulating a negative opinion. Is that not amazing? Is that not wow? I mean, this is Tiger ShantiDread. And I've been put in a box. Let me out. God bless. Love you all. YouTube family. Locked forever. Stay locked. Bless.